Good morning, everyone. So the first chapter is about completely about grammar. We have already discussed how to become good engineer. We have also discussed the orientation of English. We also discussed articles. And now today we'll start with another very new topic, which is very important from the point of view of any competitive examination too. And it is none other than conjunctions. So I'll start presenting it. Yes, there are so many sentences that we speak. There are so many occasions wherein we speak variety of sentences. But there are certain words, they help us to join them. For example, I have more than 5 sentences today to share with you guys. For example, I am a teacher. I am a lecturer. I am a student of language. I am also completing my PhD in Mumbai University. So whenever I have so many sentences at a time and I want to discuss with them, there is no need to talk about only one sentence. I can simply connect them. And the words that help me out to connect these sentences, they are nothing but conjunctions. So he watches cartoon programs, he watches Hollywood movies. Now these are 2 sentences. For the representational purpose, I have given you. And these 2 sentences are combined together by using one word, which is underlined. He watches cartoon programs and Hollywood movies. Now see, even the picture is also quite symbolic, that suggests that you need to connect them. So these 2 sentences are connected by using one conjunction, that is and. So the word that is utilized to connect or to join 2 sentences, 2 words, 2 phrases, it is called conjunction. This is what the actual definition is. A word that connects words, phrases, clauses and sentences is called conjunction. The simple definition it is. No one is going to ask you the definition. Everybody will expect you to use correct conjunction in a given situation. They may give you a blank space wherein you need to use correct preposition. Sorry, correct conjunction. So, what are the different types of things that these conjunctions connect? The first one is they connect 2 words. For example, you listen song and speech. Song and speech, these 2 nouns are there. They are connected by the word and. So, the first thing that the conjunctions does is they connect 2 words. Not only words, they also connect 2 phrases. Now let me clarify more about phrase. Phrase means it's a group of word. Group of word, it doesn't have subject, it doesn't have predicate. But it has some meaning in connected sentence. So mark my words. For example, I upload video links on YouTube. So on YouTube, this is one prepositional phrase. On Facebook, this is another prepositional phrase. As I said, phrase is just a group of word in proper sequence. But it doesn't have subject and it doesn't have object. Predicate. Point is, in isolation it may not have complete meaning, but in connected sentence it has some meaning. For example, I upload video links on YouTube or on Facebook. Now or is the word that connects these 2 phrases, on YouTube and on Facebook. So please mark my words that conjunctions not only connect 2 words, they also connect 2 phrases. Now the third function of conjunction is they connect 2 clauses. 2 clauses means group of word, it has its own subject and it has its own predicate. The clause has some meaning in isolation as well as in connected sentence. The clause which has its own meaning in isolation is the main clause. So 2 main clauses are also joined or combined by conjunction, or one main clause and one subordinate clause, they are also combined by conjunction. So the third function of conjunction is that they join 2 clauses. I called him, this is one clause, and informed that he had got the job. See, I called him, I informed him. These two sentences are there. They are combined with and. So I called him and informed him. Not only that, the third clause that he had got the job, this third clause has also been joined by the word that. So it joins words, phrases, clauses or sentences. The function nobody is going to ask you. As I said, in the coming examination also, you will be asked to use correct conjunction in a given space. Yes. Now the next point is types of conjunction. Types of conjunction you need to know. It is because in competitive examination, you may be asked different questions based on this conjunction. And as compared to preposition, conjunctions are easier. So you have ready-made mark, one or two marks in your pocket if you understand very simple three types of conjunction. The number one is coordinating, number two is subordinating, and number three one is correlative. Now the title itself suggests their meaning. As I said, nobody will ask you the meaning, but unless and until you understand what exactly coordinating conjunctions are, what exactly subordinating conjunctions are, and correlative conjunctions, you won't be in the position to use them correctly in a given situation or in a given sentence. So please understand this. Coordinating conjunctions join two words, two phrases, clauses and sentences of equal rank. Understand the word equal rank. Same status. It may be main clause, it may be a noun, it may be a pronoun, it may be a verb, it may be adverb, but they have same class, same status, equal rank and grammatical structure. Grammatical structure means if two main clauses are there, they have same structure. If two subordinate clauses are there, they have same structure. If two nouns are there, they have same parts of speech. So such words, such phrases which has equal rank, status or grammatical structure, they are connected by coordinating conjunctions. And these coordinating conjunctions are very easy to understand. You will understand, and most of the time we are using and we are very comfortable in using coordinating conjunction. Directly or indirectly or knowingly or unknowingly, majority of the time I have found that very few students commit error in using coordinating conjunction. They are the easiest. For example, they got a certificate and a trophy. There are two sentences here. They got a certificate, a main clause. They got a trophy, another main clause. Now these main clauses having same structure, same status, equal rank, they are combined by using one coordinating conjunction, that is and. And we all are very comfortable by using in the use of and. Rather, majority of the time I have found that the students, they use and very comfortably, sometimes wrongly, but they use it very confidently. So there is no question about and. The next sentence is he liked the introduction of the movie, but he felt the climax a bit boring. Now he liked the introduction of the movie, this is one clause. He felt the climax a bit boring, this is another clause, which is also a main clause. Now they are connected by one sentence, one word, that is but. So both the clauses, they have equal rank or status and they are combined by using but. I'll visit Mumbai or I will visit Bangalore. So two clauses having same rank, they are connected by or. So or, but and these are coordinating conjunctions. Nobody will ask you identify what kind of conjunction is used in a given sentence. As I said in the beginning of this session, that they will ask you exactly use the correct conjunction in a given situation or given sentence. Yes, in order to identify and keep them in mind, the very important word that you need to understand or need to keep in your memory, that fanboys. Now what does fanboy stand for? F stands for, A stands for and, N stands for no, B stands for but, O stands for or, Y stands for yet, and S stands for so. So fanboys, if you could simply remember that much, you will identify that these are for and not, but or yet so. These are coordinating conjunctions and very frequently we are using them, or we use them very frequently and we are very comfortable in using them. And this particular concept of fanboys I could come across at https://www.onlinemathlearning.com. At this website, if you go and visit, you will find this particular slide. So from there, I have got it. You simply remember fanboys and you get it. All the examples of coordinating conjunction. Now, these are the examples of coordinating conjunctions. Coordinating conjunctions, for example, for. They sat in patience for their boss was angry. Another coordinating conjunction is and. You listen opinions of your parents and your parents will listen to your mind. No. He cannot afford to waste his time in mobile games, nor can he play on ground. But he tried hard catching the thief, but the thief escaped easily. Or, I will listen speeches of Mr. Shashi Tharoor, or I will listen preaching of Sadhguru. Yet, she preferred discipline in class, yet she admired a bit of laugh in class. If you simply understand the meaning of these coordinating conjunctions, you will understand in which situation and in which context they fit in. So you should know what exactly the meaning of for and no, but or yet. Or if you simply go on using them or reading in which situation these coordinating conjunctions are used, you form one good habit, and whenever there is a situation, you are correctly using these coordinating conjunctions, and we are very comfortable in using coordinating conjunctions, as I said. Now, next type is subordinating conjunction. Subordinating conjunction is a word which joins together a dependent clause and an independent clause. Now, these two concepts are there. That let me clarify first of all these two concepts. In standard 10th also, you must have understood simple, complex and compound sentences. Now, the complex sentences wherein you have one main clause and another subordinate clause. Now, what is this main clause or principal clause is? The clause is which has subject, which has predicate, and it completes its own meaning without taking help of anyone. So that is what principal clause or main clause is. So in subordinating conjunctions, what happened is the subordinating conjunctions, they combine together one main clause, or that is independent clause, and another dependent clause. So dependent clause is the subordinate clause. Subordinate clause means a clause which has its own subject, which has its own predicate, but it depends upon the principal clause to complete its meaning. For example, you will improve your knowledge. This is main clause. If you listen to understand. So if you listen to understand, if only this much clause is uttered, you feel the sense of gap that there has to be something more to get its complete meaning. And that's why when you get, you will improve your knowledge if you listen to understand. Right? So if you listen to understand, if you utter that much, you won't get the complete meaning. And that's why it is a dependent clause, because it requires independent clause, that is principal clause, to complete its meaning. That is, you will improve your knowledge. This is the principal clause. I hope the things are getting clear. Now, these are around 50 subordinating conjunctions that I can give you, like after, although, as if, as long as much as soon as, even if, even though, if not, if when, if then, lest, now since, now that, now when, once, provided, so that, supposing, then, that, thou, till, unless, where, whereas, where if, wherever, whether, which, why. So again, I would say that I could come across this particular 50 subordinating conjunction slide at elseforum.com subordinating conjunctions. So therein you can go and you can have a look at it. So we have, up to this, we have discussed coordinating conjunctions and we also discussed subordinating conjunctions. The third part we will start.